So combined homemade leverage or unleveraged, what conclusion can we means the cap structure does not affect investors directly. Why? Because they are smart enough to replicate returns under any cap structure. So this is our first proposition one, and a world with no corporate tax. The value of the leverage cap structure equal to the value of unleveraged cap structure. Or the choice does not affect firm value directly. Another implication is this also implies firm's weighted average cost capital is the same. We want to look at the example following proposition one with no corporate tax. Suppose a company is all equity, has 80,000 shares of stock. The company is thinking borrowing 600,000 at 9% to buy back 12,000 shares of stock. What's the value of the firm if you ignore tax? So this is a no corporate tax. How do we figure it out? So remember, does not matter which cap structure you use, the firm value is the same, the total amount. Under unlevered, we have 80,000 shares. We also know that company are able to use 600,000 to buy back 12,000 shares. So means that each stock was what? $50, am I right? $50 per share. So that's the stock price. Now, think about under all equity capital structure. Each stock is 50, right? Price does not change. Then what is the firm value? You time this, we got the firm value is what? I believe it's $4 million, right? $4 million, okay. So these are solutions. I would suggest you try this following practice on your own to see if you are able to figure out the firm value. Okay. So the key is that the restructuring process, borrowing money to buy back share, you can figure out the stock price, right? From stock price, you can figure out the total firm value. The second proposition also have proposition 2. So proposition 2 answers this question. What's the effect of leverage on cost equity? Here we use the S to refer to return on equity, cost equity. And the B, R sub B, is the cost of debt or interest rate. And R sub 0 is return of unlevered capital structure. Okay, so when the company started with all equity, have no debt, the cost equity or cost capital is defined as R sub 0. Okay. So S stock, SL, is the value of levered equity. So proposition 2 said cost equity depends on unlevered cost equity. And this is leverage debt equity ratio times the difference between R sub 0 and the cost of debt. So let's see that from the chart. It's much easier to understand the impact. So the bottom, the horizon is debt equity ratio, and the vertical is cost capital. And R sub B is cost of debt. It's a bit lower. Now, so this the green line is the weighted average cost capital. So when companies' debt increase from zero to a bit more, the cost equity also proportionally increase. So the leverage effect on the cost capital is a positive and a linear and increase. Let's take a look. If cost equity for an all equity firm is 15%, companies considering a levered capital structure with the equity ratio 1 over 1. If the cost of debt is 10%, assume a world of no corporate tax, what is the cost equity under the levered capital structure? We use proposition. We need to know the notation, right? The equity ratio is 1, okay? Cost of the debt is 10. So what is R sub 0 again? The cost of capital under an all equity firm, the one with no debt. So here, it is cost equity for equity firm is 15, right? So all information is given, so we can plug into proportion 2, figure out, yes, the cost equity increased now from 15% to 20%. Let's see another example. So this company, El Paso, is a natural gas company, currently has a debt equity ratio of 2. The cost of debt is 6%. Cost of equity is 12%. Now, they are considered a new capital structure where the debt equity ratio is 1, the cost of debt is 5.5, ask you to figure out the new cost equity. Okay, so we cannot directly use the proposition 2. Why? Because where we need to find out what is R sub 0. So do you still remember what is R sub 0? It's very special. The cost equity under all equity cap structure, the one with no debt. So currently we do have some debt. So we cannot directly actually have the information on this R sub 0. But if you go back to our chart, proposition 2, although cost equity is increasing, but a cost of R sub 0, cost of capital for or equity firm, is the same as WACC. You know, the WACC remains constant. So if we know the WACC, right, we can figure that R sub 0. So what's our WACC? B over B plus S times cost equity, cost of debt plus S over B plus S times cost of equity. So remember, we have no corporate tax. So we use this first, that use this formula to figure out the WACC. So our WACC, okay, the debt, right, that is 2 over 1, right, 2 over 1. So 2 over 2 plus 1, debt is 6, plus equity, 1, right, 1 over 2 plus 1, times equity is 12, right, easily we can figure out WACC is 8%. So remember, we said R sub 0 is the same thing as WACC. WACC remains constant. So easy, we can get R sub 0 8% too. Now, can we figure out our cost equity now? Yes. Let's use proposition formula. R sub 0 is 8%. Debt equity ratio is 1. R sub 0 is 8%. The cost of debt is 5.5. So we got, I believe it's 10.5, right? Okay, 8%, 10.5. So even under new capital proposed capital structure, still not 1 over 1, still WACC is unchanged. We have finished talking MMA proposition without corporate tax. So MMA proposition 1 say, what's the impact of leverage on firm value? The answer is no. No impact, does not matter. Value remains a constant. Proposition 2, answer the question, what's the leverage effect on cost equity? We said yes, it's positive and linear, increasing. Now we're going to move on to look at MMM theory, but we're going to drop one of assumption, which is no corporate tax. So in real world, we do know that company have to pay tax. Right, so what's going to happen? The leverage effect on firm value, the leverage effect on cost equity. Okay. So under the assumption corporate tax, do they still have the same implications? MM Proposition 1 said the leverage actually is going to increase firm value. The more leverage you have, the more debt you're borrowing, the higher firm value becomes. How much more? They tell you that value of leverage capital structure equal to unlevered plus the present value of the debt effect. So what's the implication? So as you see, the firm value increase with the borrowing, with leverage. So the more money you borrow, the merrier, the higher the firm value become. So in the extreme cases, okay, the firm's optimal capital structure will be 100% debt. So there's no bankruptcy. So firm value, the capital structure doesn't matter. The second implication is on the firm's weighted average cost capital. In this case, weighted average cost capital decrease with the leverage. So let's talk about why this is the case. So in the real world, the corporation pay tax. The interest payment has tax shield, which means you deduct your interest payment from your taxable amount, right? The more you borrow, the more interest payment you have, the more amount you're going to reduce from taxable income amount. So in this case, we claim this is interest tax shield, save the tax payment for corporation. So this serves as a positive cash flow impact. So let's take a look how much is the interest tax shield. So every year, that's annual amount. So whatever you are paying interest payment, your time tax rate, this annual interest tax shield. How much is the value impact? Suppose every year you save this amount. How much is this going to increase your firm value? Okay. So we discount this at R sub B. So we got the present value of tax interest shield is just tax rate times amount of debt. Let's take examples. So if the debt amount is 6,250, interest is 8%, corporate tax 34%. So the annual interest payment is just equal to 34%. How much interest we are paying? We borrow 6,250. We are paying 8%. So how much is present value amount? So every year you save 170 and you discount by 0.08. Okay, so you will got 21.25. So this is same thing if we use 34% times amount of debt, 6,250, achieve same amount. So this is interest tax shield. You want to know what's the annual amount, what's the value, present value of this amount. So here is example for you to practice on your own. What is annual interest rate, interest tax shield, and what's the present value of interest tax shield? So second proposition is what's the impact of leverage on cost equity if we assume corporate tax. The impact is very similar. The relationship is also very similar. Remember, we still have the same notation. This is cost equity, this is the cost of capital for unlevered capital structure, debt equity ratio, cost of unlevered, cost capital for unlevered, cost of debt. The only difference is we just adjust for after-tax adjustment. So if you put them into the chart, we notice that assume corporate tax, it's still very similar. The line is also positive increasing with the leverage. And it's also, the difference is the slope is not as steep as before. The impact on WACC is the WACC no longer stay constant. WACC actually decreasing with the increase of leverage. Now, let's take a look at some examples. Suppose the company has no debt. So under a world of corporate tax, no debt. Its cost of equity is 20%. The company expects EBIT is 95,000 perpetual cash flow. Now, the company plans to borrow 60,000 at 11%, okay, to buy back some shares. So they're going to do some capital restructuring. What's the value of the firm before capital structuring? What's the value after change? What's the cost of equity and the WACC? Oh, a lot of questions. So, okay, let's do one at a time. The first question is value of the firm, okay, before change, means it's no debt or equity. So remember, all the cash flow is the perpetual cash flow, no continue forever. So remember we said the value of firm depends on if the perpetual cash flow is cash flow over discount rate, right? So we want to know what is our net income, what is our cost. So under unlevered cap structure, cost is 22%. We make 95,000 EBIT. However, we still have to pay tax because why? This is a world with corporate tax. Okay? But we don't have debt. We don't have interest payment. So the income equal to 95,000, okay? We just pay the tax. So the tax is 35%. We need to know the tax. Okay, so that's the value of the unlevered, right? Does it make sense? The income overall, the income you have to pay tax. Okay, so that's it. So what's the value of firm after the change? Means what's the change? We're going to borrow 60,000 at 8%, 11% every year. So remember, we have a proposition one. The value of levered capital structure, if we know unlevered, then we just add the interest tax shield value effect, right? TC, corporate tax, time, amount of debt. That's easy. Let's do that. So the value of levered is unlevered plus, okay, again, tax is 35. Amount of debt is 90. Amount debt is 60,000. Okay, so let's check. 95,000 times tax, okay, after tax, divide by R sub 0. Okay, so we got it. Okay, so first the second question. Third question asks you, what's the cost of equity? What's the WACC? So we're going to use the proposition 2. Take a look at the proposition 2. So what information do we need? We need R sub 0, which is 22%. That's given. Cost of debt is 11%. Tax is 34%. Okay, the debt is 60,000 amount. So the only thing we don't know is how much is equity. So imagine, right, if we know the amount of debt, then we can figure out amount of the equity. So remember, the company, we already calculated the total value under the levered capital structure. So if we know the total, if we know the amount of debt, so how much equity? Easy, right? Subtraction. So let's now take a look. So from the total, where's VL? We got it from step 2. Then we subtract, okay, subtract equity, subtract the debt, we got equity. So now, so this notation is same thing as, should put S. Then we plug into proposition 2, and things become straightforward, okay? So we got cost equity 23.78. So the WACC, okay, so this is the equity amount over total firm value, which is 301. Okay, then cost equity 23, we just got it. Debt, total firm value, cost of debt, after tax adjustment. So as you see, WACC is reduced. It's not as high, it's lower. WACC is 20.47. Right. So this example actually requires you to know the knowledge of both proposition 1, proposition 2. So we start with unlevered, then we use proposition 1 to figure out the levered. And we also infer what's the amount of equity, then use proposition 2 to figure out the cost of equity. Lastly, use WACC. So I'm going to challenge you to ask your pause and try this exercise. So again, you are asked to solve 4 questions. See if you can get it. To summarize, so we learned a member proposition under 2 assumptions. Without corporate tax, there's no capital structure choice impact on firm value, but leverage does increase cost equity. Under corporate tax, capital structure matters. The more leverage, the higher debt, increase your leverage. And the cost of equity still increase with leverage, but at a slower pace. So that's all for MMM theory.